Dallas, Texas, 4 hour each. And Zoria is in Bridgeville, Delaware, 1 hour each. Gloria is in Sorrento, Louisiana, 4 hour each.
Sandra is back from the dope one.
Yeah, I was with you.
Outreach. Arlene from
the Zones Louisiana Fund Outreach. David from the Bones of Illinois, giving one case of outreach Bibles. And then we have Lois from Winchendon, Massachusetts, two outreach Bibles. William and Joyce from Chambersburg, Virginia, one English New Testament, one outreach New Testament, and 10 outreach Bibles. Then we have Georgia from Bolton, Mississippi, four outreach Bibles praying for her son. Dolores Ward, Arkansas, one case of outreach Bibles. Mike and Ann from Comstock, Michigan, one ladies edition, two English New Testaments, and four outreach Bibles. Helen from Missouri, Texas, six outreach Bibles. Then we have Joan from Snellville, Georgia, four outreach Bibles today. Edward from Northampton, New Hampshire, six outreach Bibles. And finally, here we have Diane from Wilmington, North Carolina, four outreach Bibles. And we're going to take the top of the hour break and go online and give this morning as the Lord leads.
This is Bible Thump from the Sun Life Podcast. Last month's Bible Thump, we saw a fantastic outpouring in support of our mission to bring the gospel to the world. Your donations help our missionaries take the light of the gospel all around the globe, placing expositor study Bibles into the hands of pastors who otherwise wouldn't have access to the Word of God. Mark 16:15 tells us, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation."
Thank you for calling back.
How you'd like to donate a Bible?
Yes, thank you.
We need to reach the hearts and souls of untold millions around the world with the gospel of Jesus Christ. That's why with your continued support, you become a partner with us in the missionary work. Your contributions have allowed us to place the Word of God in the hands of pastors throughout the world. So to those of you who sought the Lord and contributed to His work this Bible Thump, we want to thank you.
The Expositor to Study Bible is one of the best sellers in the world today. There's a reason for that. Virtually every scripture is explained to help you to understand the Word of God to a greater degree than ever before. And anything that will do that is valuable indeed. But you can see on the screen the different editions that we have. We have a Bible for you, a Bible for the children, a Bible for the ladies, a Bible for young people. All of the Bibles are identical as far as text and notes are concerned. It's just the cover that's different, with the exception of this one right here. Read and Grow Picture Bible. There are over 1,800 illustrations in this Bible designed for children. If you don't have the Expositor to Study Bible, whatever edition that you want, you can see them on the screen. Select the one you like, because I want you to have that. I'm listening for your call.
From Jimmy Swaggart Ministries, it's BiblesForOutreach.org. For all active U.S. servicemen and women, as well as first responders, including law enforcement officers, fire department, and EMS workers, is a free Expositor Study Bible Counselor's Edition. Just request yours at BiblesForOutreach.org. The Expositor's New Testament Counselor's Edition is a King James Version with scripture text in Latin and Expositor's Notes in red. It's very user-friendly. In the back are scriptures that apply specifically to subjects like discouragement, financial matters, forgiveness, and salvation. It's your monthly financial support in SBN Bible Funds that covers the cost of this outreach. If you're an active duty military or a first responder and would like a free copy of the Expositor's New Testament Counselor's Edition, make your request at BiblesForOutreach.org. Hello, this is Bobby Swagger. I want to invite everyone in the Lemon, South Dakota area to come and be with me June the 7th through the 9th. I'm going to be in Lemon at New Hope Worship Center. Friday night at 7 o'clock, Saturday night at 6 o'clock, and Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. Once again, that's June the 7th through the 9th, New Hope Worship Center, Lemon, South Dakota. For more information, the phone number's on the screen, the address is on the screen, or you can go to my website, DonnieSwagger.org.
Taking the message of the cross to the world. This is the Sunlight Broadcasting Network.
I'm going back home. See if I can get back to the booth.
that might not be a high on dope.
Make a note on it.
Okay, wobble.
Saying, where is the promise of his coming?
This refers to the second.
fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. And this is the note here in the sponsors that I think is extremely important, and one of the reasons I read this. Go ahead, Brother Dave.
The two major themes of the Word of God are the atonement and end time events. If we have a proper understanding of the atonement, we'll have, I think, a proper understanding of the latter.
The two major themes of the Word of God are the atonement and end time events. If we have a proper understanding of the atonement, and that's what we believe you're going to get in the Expositor's Study Bible, we will have, I think, a proper understanding of end time events. And so, one of the reasons we encourage you to, of course, take advantage of all of the Bibles, or 50% off today, part of the Bible Thought Outreach deal, whatnot, not only that, but get involved with the outreach to send this Bible all over the world. And we've got some more slips here. Take advantage of it today, we pray. Mary from South Pasadena, Florida, 4 Outreach Bibles. Tim from Biden, Kentucky, 4 Outreach Bibles. Jody from Farmington, Missouri, 4 Outreach Bibles. Donald from Beaconsfield, Australia, 1 Case of Outreach. Bonnie from Ontario, Ohio, 8 Outreach Bibles. Dale from Corning, New York, 4 Outreach Bibles. Kathleen from Manchester, New Hampshire, 2 Outreach Bibles. Clark from Indianapolis, Indiana, 1 Case of Outreach Bibles. Eric from Clarksville, Tennessee, 1 Case of Outreach Bibles. Alice from Fitston, Oklahoma, 3 Outreach Bibles and 3 Outreach New Testaments. Daniel from Cathedral City, California, 6 Outreach Bibles. Celeste from Chicago City, Minnesota, 1 Case of Outreach Bibles. Brother Dave.
We've got Rhonda in Moraine, Ohio, 1 Case of Outreach. Evangeline and Staten Island, 7 Outreach. Tony's in San Antonio, Texas, 1 Case of Outreach. Marlon in Bradenton, Florida, 1 Case of Outreach. Betty in Georgetown, South Carolina, 1 Outreach. Helen in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, 1 Case of Outreach. Joseph in Stamford, Kentucky, 2 Outreach. Marion is in Howell, Michigan, 4 Outreach. And William and Denise in Charlotte, North Carolina, 4 Outreach Bibles.
Joseph and Dean from Sarasota, Florida, 1 Case of Outreach Bibles. Lisa from Canton, Ohio, 1 Outreach New Testament, 1 Outreach Bible. Bob and Ann from Waverly, Illinois, 1 Case of Outreach. John from Somerville, South Carolina, 5 Outreach Bibles. Nancy from Newark, Arkansas, 2 Outreach. Deborah from Marion, Wisconsin, 4 Outreach. Beverly from Greenville, Texas, 1 Case of Outreach Bibles. Mary from Richland Hills, Texas, 1 Case of Outreach. James from Portage, Indiana, 4 Outreach Bibles and a gift of $650. Bill and Linda from Kingston, Oklahoma, 6 Outreach Bibles and a gift of $50. Tim from Nagani, Michigan, 2 Outreach Bibles. Arlene from Atlanta, Kansas, 5 Outreach New Testaments and 5 Outreach Bibles. Ronald from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, 1 Outreach Bible. Anonymous from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 1 Case of Outreach and 3 additional Outreach New Testaments. Charles and Debbie from Norwood, North Carolina, 4 Outreach. Bernice from Grand, North Carolina, 1 Outreach Bible. Reed from Elkview, West Virginia, a gift of $100. Jim and Anita from Decatur, Indiana, 5 Outreach Bibles. Stacy from Albany, Kentucky, 1 regular print. Linda from Kenner, Louisiana, 2 Outreach Bibles. Linda from Conover, North Carolina, 4 Outreach Bibles. Shelly from Cottonwood, California, giving 2 Outreach Bibles today. Paul from Lodi, California, 7 Outreach New Testaments. Grace Temple Ministries from Mansfield, Texas, giving 5 Cases of Outreach Bibles. Lord, praise the Lord for that. It's great to see churches getting involved and letting the Lord use them in this outreach. And we encourage you, if you're a pastor of a church and you're looking for an outreach to get involved with, this is one you will not be disappointed that you did. Roy from Coyle, Mississippi, 2 Outreach Bibles. James and Maureen from Kirkwood, Pennsylvania, 1 Case of Outreach. Judith from Muncie, Indiana, 4 Outreach Bibles. Gloria from Clinton, Alabama, 1 Case of Outreach and 8 Outreach additionally. And then finally here we have Linda from Charlotte, North Carolina, 1 Outreach Bible. And praise God. And are we able to go to a song? Awesome.
phones if you can to help us this morning and donate toward this great work. Tony from Fort Worth, Texas, 7 outreach contestants in one case of outreach violence. Frank and Josephine from New Greenville, Pennsylvania, 7 outreach contestants in one case of outreach. And we have Mary from Caledonia, Mississippi, 1 outreach contestant and 1 case of outreach violence. John from Louisville, Kentucky, 4 outreach violence. Sandra from Sallis, South Carolina, 3 outreach Bibles. Then we have Joyce from Fort Smith, Arkansas, 4 outreach Bibles. Skip and Sandy from Alabaster, Alabama, 1 case of outreach Bibles. Then we have Cynthia from Fruitport, Michigan, 1 Crossfire Edition and 1 Ladies Edition, and 3 outreach Bibles. Norman and Jody from Texarkana, Texas, 3 cases of outreach Bibles. Sherry from Garner, Iowa, 2 outreach contestants and 1 outreach Bible. Then we have Gracie from Crewe, Virginia, 1 case of outreach Bibles. Then Bernice from Greenwood Lake, New York, 4 outreach Bibles. Edna from East Point, Florida, 2 reading rows and 2 outreach contestants. And then Anonymous from Beaver Falls, Pennsylvania, 4 outreach Bibles.
We got Sissy in Gonzales, Virginia. Sissy Gonzales, Virginia. They put an E there, so Sissy. 4 outreach Bibles. Lynn in Camp Hill, Pennsylvania, 1 giant print and 1 case of outreach. George in Gloucester, Massachusetts, 3 cases of outreach and 3 additional outreach. Dan and Carol are in New Braunfels, Texas, 1 case of outreach. Walter and Kim in Port Huron, Port Huron, Michigan. 1 regular print, 1 English New Testament, 1 case of outreach. Wanda is in Hilton, Oklahoma, 4 outreach. Manny is in Pennsylvania, 2 outreach. Priscilla is in Lenora, Tennessee, 1 outreach. Norma in Fort Payne, Indiana, 1 case of outreach. Media members, Wayne and Margie in Aiken, Minnesota, 3 cases of outreach. Carolyn in Elwood, Indiana, 1 Crossfire Edition, 1 Ladies Edition, and 8 outreach. Julia in Argyle, Texas, 4 outreach. Donnie is in North Carolina, Fuquay, Verena, North Carolina, 5 outreach. Ramona in Pascagoula, Mississippi, 1 Crossfire Edition, 1 Signature Edition. Teresa in Lake Alfred, Florida, 3 outreach contestants, 6 outreach Bibles. Nancy in Lake City, Florida, 3 outreach Bibles. And Olivia in South Bay, Texas, 1 outreach Bible.
As we've said multiple times this morning, we are repeated. We are reaching the total for Zambia, 8,310 Bibles. First of all, once we knock that out, we move on to Nigeria, 12,500. But one of the most exciting things today, first time ever, for Sunlight Broadcasting, this outreach for Expositor Study Bibles is moving on to the French edition. My first time for this outreach, and it's going to the Democratic Republic of the Congo, French-speaking country, as well as France and Gabon. And about 36,000-37,000 Bibles total for those three countries. And so once we knock these two out, we can move on to that brand new French edition. And Robert is called in today with a gift of 11 cases of outreach Bibles. And that matches this morning's largest gift. And we're so thankful for that, Brother Robert. 11 cases was given earlier, and now 11 cases once again. Praise God for that. How many Bibles is that? About 132. Yeah. There you go. And praise God for that. Thank you so much, Brother Robert. And we need as many as we can get, just like it. Just like it. Got about, again, 35 minutes until we close this shift down. So, hey, one of those phones or go online. Of course, online would be the best way to give this morning. Madeline from Louisville, Ohio, 2 outreach Bibles. Norma from Toloka, Oklahoma, 2 outreach Bibles. Charles of Conley, Georgia, 7 outreach Bibles. Betty from Columbia, Mississippi, 2 outreach Bibles. Sandra from Bay City, Michigan, 1 case of outreach Bibles. Justin and Bob. Cleveland, Tennessee. Three outreach Bibles.
All right, we've got Sylvester is in Sanford, Florida, six outreach. Lucille is in Arnold, Pennsylvania, one outreach New Testament, two outreach Bibles. Lucille needs prayer. Lucille's got a painful that's very painful. Father, we pray for Lucille today. We ask the Lord to just touch her there in Pennsylvania. Lord, I know this is a painful thing. We ask for relief, Lord, from pain. Ask for these shingles to clear up. In Jesus' name, touch Lucille. Amen. Donna is in Harvey's Lake, Pennsylvania, six outreach. This is Vetolu in Aurora, Colorado, four outreach. And Walmart in Durham, North Carolina, two outreach.
All right, online, Andy and Brittany from Tennessee.
There's one of them just doing it, but you have a...
Fifth in Georgia, one outreach New Testament, one outreach Bible. Rebecca from Iowa Park, Texas, two outreach Bibles. Connie Ann from New York, gets $25. Sam and O'Neill from Logan, Texas, one case of outreach Bibles. Leifert from South Canada, four outreach Bibles. Linda from Strasburg, Virginia, one case of outreach Bibles. Eric from Clarksville, Tennessee, seven outreach New Testaments. Linda from Dartmouth, Canada, one outreach Bible. And for those of you in Canada, I'll be coming to Newfoundland in just about 3 weeks. I'll be there June the 21st through the 23rd. Deer Lake, Newfoundland, returning. Second time there. We had a wonderful service, a group of meetings last year. Looking forward to the same. June the 21st through the 23rd in Deer Lake, Newfoundland. Debbie from Gilman, Mississippi, two outreach Bibles. Amy from Elkhart, Indiana, two outreach Bibles and one outreach New Testament. Leroy from LaSalle, Wisconsin, three outreach New Testaments. Elizabeth from Franklin, Massachusetts, two outreach Bibles. Then we have Keith from Zanesville, Ohio, two outreach Bibles. Mark and Diane from Rumsey, Kentucky, one case of outreach. Donna from Washington, D.C., one outreach Bible. Michelle from St. Clair Shores, Michigan, eight cases of outreach Bibles. Praise God. Eight cases. Lenny and Stacy from Jamaica, New York, one case of outreach. Corrine from Baltimore, Maryland, five outreach. Margina from Carmel, New York, 10 outreach Bibles and 2 outreach New Testaments. Daryl from Wichita, Kansas, a gift of $270. Pamela from Chicago, Illinois, 3 outreach New Testaments and 3 outreach Bibles. Jen from Indiana, 6 outreach. Matt and Dana from Baton Rouge, 4 outreach Bibles. Larry and Nancy from Texas, 3 cases of outreach Bibles. Phyllis from St. John's, Florida, a gift of $25. Christian from Camino, California, giving one case of outreach Bibles. Susan from Lewis, Delaware, two outreach Bibles and two outreach New Testaments. Janie from Newport Richey, Florida, one case of outreach. Joe from Crockett, Texas, giving seven outreach Bibles. Marie from Grove City, Pennsylvania, four outreach Bibles. Diane from Worcester, Ohio, seven outreach New Testaments. Rebecca from B, Arkansas, six outreach Bibles. Elizabeth from Franklin, Massachusetts, one outreach Bible. And Betsy from Toronto, Canada, one case of outreach. Dustin, Holy Tree, one case of outreach Bibles, and four outreach New Testaments.
We've got Pete and Sherry, Apache Junction, Arizona, four outreach. Jimmy in Aubrey, Texas, one case of outreach. Rick and Deborah, New Carlisle, Ohio, media church members, one case of outreach. Harold and Melissa, Marrero, Louisiana, eight outreach. Rommel in Santa Clara, New Mexico, one case of outreach. Darlene, Dayton, Tennessee, one outreach. Tracy and Beverly is in Belleville, Mississippi, one outreach. Barbara in Center, Texas, four Reed and Grow, and three cases of outreach. Bobby and Gracie, Smithville, Tennessee, two outreach New Testaments, one case of outreach Bibles. And Roy in Waynesboro, Pennsylvania, one outreach New Testament, and one outreach Bible.
All right, we've got about 30 minutes left. So we get to the end of this shift this morning. We've done wonderfully. You've done wonderfully. We ask you to keep it up and go online, sunlifetv.com, and give today toward this Bible Fund outreach. And when we go to some music, you go online and give today. So,
in the 1950s, he wrote something great. Texas 5 Outreach, Wanda, Chickasha, Oklahoma, once Spanish New Testament, and one case of Outreach Bibles. Dale and Kathy from Cumming, Georgia, three Outreach Bibles. Raymond, Grand City, Illinois, four Outreach Bibles. Then we have Jerome from Tinley Park, Illinois, one case of Outreach. William and Sherry from Pat. Can't make out the city here, but Michigan. Oh, it's Hastings, Michigan. That's four Outreach Bibles. Pauline from Cungie, Pennsylvania, four Outreach Bibles. Evelyn from Albany, Outreach Bibles. Vicky, Ford City, Pennsylvania, three Outreach New Testaments and one Outreach Bible. Jerry from Brunswick, Georgia, four Outreach Bibles. Guy from Charlotte, North Carolina, 10 Outreach Bibles. Philip and Ella May from Seagrove, North Carolina, one case of Outreach Bibles. Terry and Jerry from Clovis, California, one case of Outreach Bibles.
We got Cynthia Levine, Arizona, one Crossfire Edition. Frank and Susan in Burridge, Illinois, three cases of Outreach. James and Gloria in Pinckney, Michigan, one case of Outreach. And this is in memory of James. James is now with the Lord, and we rejoice that he was saved. Karen, Crowley, Louisiana, four Outreach. Anonymous Media Church member in Pennsylvania, one case of Outreach. Elizabeth and Carlos are in Houston, Texas, six Outreach. And Joseph in Columbus, Ohio, one Outreach.
I'm going to throw in a little curveball for a song here. This is from an old crusade, and I'll give him a second to find it. But it's Dudley Smith singing Meeting in Glory Land. And I think it was a Florida crusade, if I'm not mistaken. But at that Meeting in Glory Land, I'd love to hear it. And we'll pick up to pick up the tempo a little bit. And here we are, 22 minutes to the end of this shift. Done wonderfully this morning. And go online at sunlighttv.com and help us this morning with these Bibles, these Outreach Bibles. And of course, we're going to move on to the French Outreach Bible for the first time today on this Bible-thon for June. And to some of you are wondering where Brother Swigert is this morning, of course, he's resting at home. If you haven't heard, of course, he is recovering from an injury. And we're praying God's speedy recovery his way. Praying that he'll be back where he belongs very, very quickly. And so go to those phones, go online, and help us this morning to finish out this morning shift. We're going to go over this song, if they have a chance to find it. Well, we're going to give them a second. At that Meeting in Glory Land, Brother Dudley Smith, and it's a wonderful song. And if they can't get to it, we'll find it after the one they do have. We're going to go to the song, you go online and give this one.
so to this, the end of this shift, and have done a great job. Every one of you have gotten involved. We're so thankful for your contribution today. And if you haven't yet, you still have time to get involved with what we think is the best shift of the day.
Yeah.
And of course, we're filling in for Brother Swagger this morning.
And Mike's running in.
Mike's running in now, so we got a few slips to read, and then we'll go to a song. Greg from Sandia, Texas. Two cases of outreach Bibles. Margene from Rising Sun, Ohio. Two outreach Bibles, two ladies edition. Charlotte from Englewood, Tennessee. Two outreach Bibles. Robin from Sheridan, Missouri. Two outreach Bibles. Yolanda from Auburn, New Mexico. One case of outreach. Then Cecil from Apache Junction, Arizona. One case of outreach. Francis from Laredo, Texas. Six outreach Bibles. One outreach New Testament. William from Des Moines, Iowa. Four outreach Bibles. Jerome from Commerce City, Colorado, 10 outreach Bibles, and a gift of $845. David from Lincolnton, North Carolina, one case of outreach. Lawrence from Willow, Missouri, 9 outreach Bibles, and 2 outreach New Testaments. Roland, Kings Mountain, North Carolina, one case of outreach Bibles. Johanna from Round Rock, Texas, 4 outreach Bibles. Then we have William from Noriko, North Carolina, 2 outreach Bibles. Deborah from Virginia, 2 outreach. Jan. Massachusetts, 6 outreach Bibles and 5 outreach New Testaments. Glenda from Pansy, Alabama, gift of $20. Jim and Donna from Alabama. 10 cases of outreach Bibles. Praise the Lord for that. And a case of regular print as well. So 11 cases total. And that matches our two largest gifts of 11 cases this morning. So there's a third. Praise God for that. 4 outreach Bibles as well. Randy from Little River, South Carolina, gift of $380. Ron from Plantation, Florida, 8 outreach Bibles. Jason and Courtney from the Funny X Springs, Florida, a gift of $150.
Well, I heard that was going to
ask for a good
one.
Randy from South Carolina, 2
and Rob Stone.
Dana from Canton, Georgia, 6 outreach Bibles. Ruth from Kansas City, Missouri.
We're going to make another double
one. Then we have Tom from Woodstock, Georgia. 10 cases of outreach Bibles. Praise God for that. Amen. Delma from Zion, Illinois. 1 case of outreach Bibles. Georgia and Dorothy from Spiro, Oklahoma. 4 outreach. Paul and Thomas from, Paul and Teresa from Burlington, Wisconsin. 4 outreach Bibles. Donna from Altoona, Wisconsin. 4 outreach Bibles. Merlene from Port St. Lucie, Florida. 2 outreach Bibles. Alexander and Hesse from Riceboro, Georgia, 2 outreach Bibles. Tommy from Allen, Oklahoma, 4 outreach Bibles, has a prayer request, healing for her eyes. Charles from Kennett, Missouri, giving 1 case of outreach Bibles.
We got Audrey Bloomingdale, Georgia, 2 outreach. Dana in Binghamton, New York, 1 case of outreach. Wayne and Diana, Liberty, Missouri, 6 outreach. James and Joan in Manassas, Virginia, 8 outreach. Media member Margaret, Victoria, Texas, 1 case of outreach. Media member Daniel in Beatrice, Nebraska, 2 outreach. Joe in Wayne City, Illinois, 4 outreach. Jim and Maxine, Walker, Louisiana, 3 cases of outreach. Ruth in Dallas, Texas, 8 outreach. Sharon in Lake Placid, Florida, 5 outreach. Donald in Springville, California, 5 outreach. And Laura in Peru, Illinois, 4 outreach Bibles.
All right. We've got about 12 minutes. Go online to give this morning. Get involved with this Bible-thon outreach. And let the Lord bless you as you do.
Yeah.
Michigan, 7 Outreach New Testaments, and 4 Outreach Bibles. Paul from Rio Grande, Nevada, giving 2 Outreach Bibles. And we're praying for your family today. Ginger from Sibley, Louisiana, 1 Outreach Bible. Pearl from Elkins Park, Pennsylvania, 4 Outreach Bibles. James G. from Swainsboro, Georgia, 6 Outreach Bibles. Rose, Olympia, Washington, 1 case of outreach and 2 outreach Bibles additionally. Anonymous from Albuquerque, New Mexico, 8 outreach Bibles today. Anita from Manassas, Virginia, 1 outreach New Testament, 10 outreach Bibles. David and Tammy from Zanesville, Ohio, 2 outreach Bibles. James from Salford, Pennsylvania, 12 regular prints and 10 cases of outreach Bibles. Amen. Yes, 10 cases. Praise the Lord for that. Thank you, Brother James. I was going to look at this. And Janet and James from Greenville, Ohio, 7 Outreach New Testaments and 7 Outreach Bibles. Beverly from Rochester, New York, 2 Outreach New Testaments. And then we have Jim and Jerry from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 9 Outreach Bibles. And Betty from Miamisburg, Ohio, 4 Outreach Bibles.
Yeah, each of them.
Ron in Grand Junction, Colorado, 2 cases of outreach. Dana in Bowling Green, Ohio, 8 outreach. Richard and Cynthia, Aiken, South Carolina, 2 outreach. And this is in memory of Kerry Hemmings, so we appreciate that donation. Mabel in Las Cruces, Mexico, 2 outreach New Testaments, 2 outreach Bibles. Donna in Independence, Missouri, 1 case of outreach Bibles and 1 regular print. Phyllis in Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, 2 outreach. John in Afton, Michigan, 1 case of outreach. Shirley is in Norway, good to hear from Norway. And Shirley's giving 8 outreach. Kathy in Fuquay, Verena, North Carolina, 3 Crossfire Edition. Rachel in Parksville, North Carolina, 5 outreach New Testaments. And Helen is in Dayton Beach, Florida, 2 outreach Bibles.
Steven from Mayfield, Kentucky, 2 outreach Bibles, an additional $100. Mike from California, give $100. Doug, Denver Springs, Louisiana, 1 case of outreach. Ralph from Laurel, Clarksville, Tennessee, 1 case of outreach. Fred, Roseburg, Oregon, 4 outreach Bibles. 7 outreach New Testaments. And then we have Dr. Dan and Mary Catherine from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 4 outreach Bibles. And Carol from Milton, Wisconsin, 1 outreach Bible. Joyce from Florida, 2 outreach Bibles. And a gift of $100. Randy and Wendy from Hamilton, Canada, 2 outreach Bibles. Gloria from Monroe, Ohio, 4 outreach Bibles. Gary from Ohio, 1 case of outreach. Then we have David and Beverly from Sun City, Center, Florida, giving 3 outreach Bibles. We've got Danielle from New Rochelle, New York, 1 outreach Bible today. And then we've got John from Selbyville, Delaware, 4 outreach New Testaments. And Larry and Debbie from Logan, Ohio, giving 2 outreach Bibles. Doug and Yvonne from Bermuda Dunes, California, 10 cases of outreach Bibles. And they give every share amount of Bible fund. We thank you so much for your involvement today. And always, Brother Doug, Sister Yvonne, and 10 outreach New Testaments as well. Dr. D from Leesville, Louisiana, gives $150. Penny and Larry from Pittsburgh, Oklahoma, 1 case of outreach. Lita from Clay Center, Kansas, 2 outreach Bibles. Angela from Doug, Virginia, 7 outreach Bibles. Mark from Shelby, North Carolina, 4 outreach Bibles. And a gift of $100. Sheila from Burton, Kansas, 1 case of outreach Bibles. Frank and Denise from Pickerington, Ohio, 2 outreach. Maria from Indianapolis, Indiana, 1 outreach Bible. Tanya from Valley Park, Missouri, 2 outreach Bibles. Sandy from Orly, Michigan, 1 case of outreach. And Marcia from Maine, 2 cases of outreach Bibles. And then we have James from Kennedy, New York, 4 outreach Bibles. mic just ran in. We got just a few more here. Right on time. We got Stephanie from Columbus, Ohio. One Outreach Bible. Larry and Janice from Tacoma, Georgia. Two Outreach New Testaments and one case of Outreach Bibles. Then we have Anonymous from Bakersfield, California. One case of Outreach. Anita from McAllister, Oklahoma. Eight Outreach. Eli from Walnutport, Pennsylvania. Three Outreach Bibles. Jay from Dawson Springs, Kentucky. One Outreach New Testament. Jeffrey from Rising Sun, Oklahoma. Ohio. One case of Outreach. Then we have Tracy from, let's see here, Georgia, four Outreach Bibles. Evelyn from Newport, Kentucky, four Outreach Bibles. Then we have Anonymous from Bedford, Ohio, four Outreach New Testaments, four Outreach Bibles. Colleen from Hillsborough, Ohio. Give me one case of Outreach Bibles. Daniel and Barbara from Gate City, Virginia, two Outreach Bibles. And Colleen from Hillsborough, Tennessee, six Outreach Bibles. Renita and Milton, New York, one Outreach.
Never dropping. And he gone.
The Bible is one of the best sellers in the world today. That's the reason for that. Virtually every scripture is explained to help you to understand the Word of God to a greater degree than ever before. And anything that will do that is a different indeed. But you can see on the screen the different editions of the Bible. We have a Bible for you, a Bible for children, a Bible for believers, a Bible for young people. Exception of this one right here. Read and read if you want to know over 1,800 illustrations in this Bible designed for children. If you don't have the sponsor to study whatever edition that you want, you can see it on the screen.
I'm a peer even.
From Jimmy Swaggart Ministries, it's Bible for Outreach.org. For all active U.S. servicemen and women, as well as first responders, including law enforcement officers, fire department, and EMS workers, is a free expositor study Bible counselor's edition. Just request Luke at BibleForOutreach.org. The expositor's New Testament counselor's edition.
There's a reason behind that.
Yes.
There are The country of Africa, for the most part, I've only been one time. My dad's been almost 30 times.
Yes.
27, 28 times, something like that, the country of Africa. My grandfather's preached crusades all over Africa. And they need the gospel. They need the gospel. They need, and you know, there is a need for Bibles in that country. And in fact, you know, we've got two of the countries that are coming up. Dad mentioned them yesterday, the Democratic Republic of Congo and Gabon. Both of those are French-speaking countries in Africa.
Yes.
And so it is our goal, our mission, to flood the country of Africa with Bibles.
We've been waiting with our ministry for this French edition to come out. We have missionaries and superintendents all over the continent, that French-speaking countries, yes, that are waiting for that. That when they were available, that we will begin to ask and take Bibles there also.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah, we're looking forward to that.
Today is an awesome opportunity. So not only are we finishing out Zambia, which we need less than 2,000 to go to get there, about 1,500 really, to get to our goal of 8,310, which will knock out the country of Zambia through you.
Yes.
And then we will move on to Nigeria, 12,500. And then, of course, for the rest of the day, once we finish Nigeria, we will then move on to those three French-speaking countries. It will be the first time that we're offering the Expositor Study Bible French edition going into these countries. Of course, this is the a very tremendous, tremendous thing to see that this Bible has been translated into the French language. And when you really look at the French language, it's one of those beautiful languages there is. It's I wish I learned how to speak it, but don't even try it. I had an undergrad, when I was an undergrad in 2019, I had to take a Spanish course. And it's pretty much a self-taught 7 weeks. And I literally was like, the moment that I finished that 7 weeks, I got an A in it, but I mean, I studied probably 5-6 hours a day. And so I was talking to a pastor buddy of mine, we were in the same class together, Pastor Kevin Vogel. And we actually connected in that class and got to be friends. We actually would test each other FaceTime or whatever the case. He came by here just a few months ago, and we were reminiscing about that, and asked us, do you remember anything? He's like, absolutely not.
You more have to decipher the sentences, yeah, and things than the actions.
It's going through and conjugating the sentences, and it's very backwards from the way they
use the sentences. It's almost better when I've heard them, people go to locations and they just do it by emerging themselves.
Yeah.
Yes. Because you have to learn to think.
Yes, you do.
In that language, you just can't translate in your head.
So, but when you listen to the French language, though, it's one of the most beautiful languages that there is. Spanish, the same way, it's a beautiful language. Italian's a beautiful language, and so this is a tremendous thing to see that this Bible's been translated.
The French language has been spread around just like with the English. I mean, the Vietnamese people have a lot of French influence because they were, you know, French were there as well, so they've been all over the place, kind of like the British at one time or another.
Isn't French the second most spoken?
Spanish.
Yeah.
I think Spanish is
probably the third.
But yeah, so it's up there though. But you know, it's a yeah. He's gonna go Google it right now.
I'll Google everything. I want to know the top 10 now.
But as we begin the second half in this first hour,
yeah.
Well, let's finish up the country of Zambia. And as Pastor Armstrong said, that it's on the water right now, heading towards Zambia. We'll be there in the next 6 weeks or so. And then that's whenever you will be able to play.
Oh, yes. What's wrong?
Spanish.
French is fourth.
Yeah. What's third?
The second is Mandarin.
Mandarin.
Then they said it's in Spanish.
Okay. All right. There you go.
There you go. Those numbers.
But we were all.
I know nothing.
All of us. So anyway, we got to take our break right now. When we come back, we're waiting for some slips to come in. I know we had a shift change here, but we had one upstairs as well. And so let's get this ball rolling here as we come back. So Randy, why don't you give those numbers real quick, please?
All right, if you call local, it's 768-3401. That's a 225 area code. If you need to hit it
or you can call 1-888-768-3401. That'll get you anywhere in the U.S. And then check the screen on the bottom that scrolls all your international numbers. But don't forget, we're doing sunlighttv.com. Is that the web?
Yeah, I guess that's.
I think that's it. If it's not, somebody will tell me. Look on the screen for that website as well. And that's the easiest way to get yourself into the groove of giving. And we would sure appreciate hearing or writing something from your lovely people.
This is Bible Thumper from the Sun Life Broadcasting Network. From Jimmy Swaggart Ministries, it's BiblesForOutreach.org. For all active U.S. servicemen and women, as well as first responders, including law enforcement officers, fire department, and EMS workers, is a free expositor study Bible counselor's edition. Just request yours at BiblesForOutreach.org. The Expositor's New Testament Counselor's Edition is a King James Version with scripture text in black and expositor's notes in red. It's very user-friendly. In the back are scriptures that apply specifically to subjects like discouragement, financial matters, forgiveness, and salvation. It's your monthly financial support in SBN Bible funds that covers the cost of this outreach. If you're an active duty military or a first responder and would like a free copy, Expositor's New Testament Counselor's Edition. Make your request at BiblesForOutreach.org. This is Gabriel Swaggart, President of Jimmy Swaggart Bible College. For over 30 years, JSBC is preparing students for ministry, whether it's pastors or teachers. With the Word of God as the cornerstone of our curriculum, we are preparing students for lifelong experiences. I promise every prospective student a well-rounded education on this beautiful campus where people are respected and true Christian faith is practiced. As the grandson of Evangelist Jimmy Swaggart, I can assure you that your time spent here will result in three things. Number one, an understanding of the message of Jesus Christ and the crucified. Number two, what it means to be thoroughly Pentecostal. And number three, how to apply the Word of God.
Jimmy Swaggart Bible College, spiritually minded,
academically sound.
Right in there.
From Madison, Alabama, 4 hours.
you want that? I need it.
Joanne Mantu, Illinois. One case of outreach Bibles. Pray for Brother Swagger's recovery, his root family. Cecil from Flushing, New York. One outreach New Testament. One outreach Bible. But you know, and we're excited all the way. We're also going to do that. We're going to take a break in just a second. But before we do that, Pastor Armstrong, just about, this is about 2 months ago, you were in Israel.
Yes.
You were actually invited with several other ministers to go to the country of Israel. It was a pretty intense time. You had a lot of people just to just talk about your experiences there in Israel.
Sure. I was there in mid-March. We went from the Lebanese border, the Syrian border, to Gaza. Everything in between. The country is under siege. That's what is happening there. What that is not said, what condemnation is anyone that went in 4 kilometers of the border of Israel is a hotel room. Ever since October 7th of last year. Every hotel in Israel is full, but it's not full of people. It's just full of Israeli citizens that can't get out of home. The neighborhoods are schools, the hotels they were in had schools at the basement, daycare, in the lobby, makeshift gang rooms in the ballrooms, all the folks in the lobbies and playing cards in the daytime, pastime, every hotel in the country is full. Israeli citizens that cannot go home, the phones, walking by, and the threat of terrorist attack from Hezbollah and Hamas. There's things that are just not being said. We have this idea right now that Israel is starving the Palestinian people when Israel themselves are sending in 6,000 to 10,000 trucks a week of humanitarian aid from Israel, not allowing other countries from the government of Israel bringing the food in and the humanitarian supplies. Yes, they're in a war. Yes, it's terrible. But Israel's not starving the Palestinian people. Israel were the victims in this situation. It's not just the genocide. It's the hunger from the river to the sea. That is the genocide that we need to understand. When you hear from the river to the sea, they're not talking about the song that we sing that we're going to go out and possess the country from the Jordan to the sea. They're talking about eradicating the Jews and the Jewish bloodline from the Jordan River that brought them into the Mediterranean Sea. They're resilient people that need our prayer. Their people needs our prayer. Everywhere we went, in a normal time, there would be buses, tourists, everywhere waiting in line. Everywhere we went, we were the only people there.
Yeah.
And we were so noticeable that the Israeli people, the Jewish people, stopped us in the street everywhere we went and said, "Hey, why are you here?" And we would tell them that they had, and strangers would have you back and say, "Thank you for being here for our people. Thank you for going home and telling our story. Thank you for praying for us." They need us. They need our prayer. They need our support. And they need us to tell the truth about what is going on here. There are people under attack. They're demon-possessed enemy. That's what it is.
Yes.
They were attacked on the early morning hours of their seventh day when they knew that they would be off guard. And their homes and their streets. I get spent a lot of time talking about it and praying for the people of Israel. They need us today.
Amen. We've got to take our break. This is my phone from the Sunlight Broadcasting Network.
Last month's Bible Dawn, we saw a fantastic outpouring of our mission to bring the gospel to the world. Organizations help our missionaries take the light of the gospel all around the globe, placing expositor study Bibles into the hands of pastors who otherwise would have access to the Word of God. Mark 16:15 tells us, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation."
like
Scripture still says it. If we bless Israel, God will bless us.
Amen.
If we curse Israel, God will curse us.
That's correct.
And I just want to say this to all those colleges that are cursing Israel right now. You better be very careful. You're treading thin ice. God does not put up with that kind of nonsense.
Even our national representatives, several of them, are
they should have been friends.